The revelation was made by Andrew Nyumba, the acting secretary, Uganda Land Commission, while appearing before Parliament's Foreign Affairs Committee, which is investigating the whereabouts of the land titles of the properties owned by Uganda's missions abroad. He indicated that land titles for most properties of foreign missions are nowhere to be seen.
Upon thorough investigation, we have discovered that we have titles / ownership documentation for 14 out of the 40 mission properties.
Came here and said that there were certain titles that they did not have. And yet on the list of what we forwarded to the chairperson in 2017, those titles were included. Now that they have one, I'm sure they can find the second. Because they did not dispute that they did not respond to our letter saying they did not have those titles.
Mm-hmm. Nora Bijira, the chairperson Foreign Affairs Committee, asked the Commission and Ministry of Foreign Affairs to harmonize their records after it was revealed that even the land title for the Ministry of Foreign Affairs is missing after officials from the Commission denied being in possession of this land title.
How do you even say that you don't even have the title for our ministry headquarters? I didn't see it here.
We note Uganda High Commission in Pretoria, 297 Groot Street, Waterkloof Ridge, Pretoria, storied building with a basement, two-storied building with a basement. We capture the measurements and we state categorically it's an official residence and that it has a fixed lease period of 6 months. That is what was on the title, and that this property was acquired in 1995. And Madam Chair, we also have information to that effect. I have correspondences here, and indeed that this title is under the custody of Uganda Land Commission.
According to the Uganda Land Commission, the titles include some two properties in New York City, two properties in Kinshasa, Democratic Republic of Congo, two properties in Abuja, Nigeria, among others. Nyumba also informed the committee that the land title for the ambassador's residence has been found while the title for the chancery is still missing.
A very thorough search, we were able to land on the title for the official residence. And it is comprised in ERF 515 Waterkloof Ridge Township, Pretoria. It is a two-story building with a basement. So we have a deed of transfer, which is the title.
Uganda Land Commission also revealed that only 26.8% of the government land has been titled, yet public land makes 23% of the total land area of Uganda, which is approximately 241,038 square kilometers, including national parks, gazetted game reserves, water bodies, wetlands, and other protected areas.
However, only about 26.28% of this land is titled.
The Committee of Foreign Affairs registered disappointments with the ministers in charge of lands who snubbed today's meeting that was meant to resolve land issues of foreign mission.
To use our powers as a committee and as parliament to cause you to do the needful on behalf of this country. But meanwhile, the information that we have got from ULC and our own Ministry of Foreign Affairs, we are going ahead to have our report put together and demand that the Ministry of Lands comes up with its submission that maybe you're willing to present before the entire House.
The probe into land titles of Uganda's missions abroad was sanctioned by the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Taibwa, following reports that Uganda's High Commission in Pretoria had mortgaged the two land titles to acquire accommodation for their staff, hence reducing on accommodation expenditure without approval of Parliament. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.